Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my online dynasty in NCAA 14. Well, it's really not my online dynasty, but I participate in the Burns 2211 Mountain West Conference Dynasty, and I popped on here to play my third game, and oh, lo and behold, I'm playing number one Alabama, and I'm doing it on the road. Okay, so I've been set up to be fodder for the Alabama Crimson Tide. Yep, they plan to have me come in and roll all over me. So this should be really interesting since we're already 0-2 with the Colorado State Rams. Can we hang in this game? I guess that's the question. A.J. McCarron back to throw, and he's going to connect with Amari Cooper there for a 17-yard reception and first down. So here comes Alabama. McCarron to throw once again. Finds his tight end Vogler, and it will be another first down. They're driving here. We're actually doing a pretty good job of not giving up big chunks of yardage, but they keep converting on third down, which is a problem. McCarron gets another first down there on his own. We do get him in a third down and seven situation, and that ball's floated and picked off by Elliott. He gets in front of it, and he's going the other way. He's not particularly fast, but they haven't gotten him yet. Could he go all the way? Oh my goodness, look at this. The Rams defense comes through with a pick six, and it's an NCAA record 100-yard touchdown return. At least I think they gave him 100 on it. Wow, I cannot believe it. We definitely were on our heels there, could not stop them on any third down situation until that one, and now we've got a 7-0 lead deep into the first quarter here. Wow, okay. Wow, that's not really what I was expecting. I keep saying wow, as I was not expecting to have a lead at any point in this ball game. So, uh-oh, did we just give it right back? Look at this. He might go tripped up at the 25-yard line or so. Oh, wow, that could have been a touchdown return to negate what we had just done. But a nice play on third and four by Bernard Blake to knock that ball down. And once again, we made a stop. Here they're going to try to kick a field goal, which shouldn't be much of a problem from that range, and they hit it. So another big moral victory here. Forget moral victory. A big victory for Colorado State making a stop there. They get the ball back with just under a minute left, and it's time to try to get the two-minute offense working. That's a first down. Let's see on second and 10. Smith over the middle. Hansley's going to fight. Oh, look at that. He put a nice shoulder in there and gets the first down in 15 yards. 13 seconds now. Smith is going to throw for another first down. That's Austin Gray making the 11-yard catch. Hey, we might be in field goal range here. First and 10. Under 10 seconds. But look at this. Wide open is Hansley. He is down to the 2-yard line. Oh, it's a shame he didn't get in there, though, because we got 5 seconds left, had to take our last timeout, and a choice here for Bonesaw Bradshaw. He's going to go for a quick hitter, but no, it's picked off in the end zone. They get no points, and we're going to go to the half up 7-3, which is amazing, but it could have been 14-3, it could have been 10-3 at least. Instead, we get no points. That hurts because we were right there at the 5-yard line. Hopefully that doesn't come back to bite us, but look at the time of possession. They've got it all over us here. 8.5 minutes to 3.5 minutes, basically. But our defense has been amazing. It's actually held us in this game, and I mean, I can't believe we got a 7-3 lead at the half. We're late in the third quarter now. McCarron's got way too much time, and look at this. His receiver comes back for the ball, and they get the big 37-yard play. Now, here is a little bit of a rant or a gripe about NCAA football in general. This game, I'm telling you, this is very frustrating because when a receiver does this to you when they got all day and they break off their route and they start running back towards the football, you're going to complete this pass as the computer 100% of the time because the defense never reacts properly to a man coming back to the football. It's unfortunate that my defense played so well and I get burned on that play. And look, all of a sudden, he's shrugging off people, and of course, they are in the end zone with TJ Yeldon getting the 10-yard touchdown rush. Very frustrating at this point because my defense has been played out of their mind, and I got burnt on that broken pass play. So here we go, down 10-7. We're not going to pack it in here. We're going to try to come down here and at least tie this ball game up. So with 5 minutes remaining, Smith is going to throw to the sideline, and that's a catch. Nice job by Pixley to stay in bounds and make the first down catch. Okay. So first and 10, and it's a handoff. Here we go, right up the middle. Surprised him a little bit and got another first down. Great job right there. Now watch the clock here. We don't really want to give the ball back to Alabama if we have anything to say about it. Here is a big play on 3rd and 11. Oh, but 1 yard short. 4th and 1. Big decision. Bonesaw Bradshaw sends the offense back out. And the fullback, Joe Brown, goes ahead for 2 yards and a big first down. Now look at this clock. We're under 2 minutes now. Smith, 2nd and goal. Finds Gilmore. Nice catch in traffic. And he is down to the 1, maybe 1.5 yard line. It'll be 3rd and goal, and we're under a minute. Smith is barking out the calls. Quarterback sneak. No, they can't quite get the push to get in. And now it'll be 4th and goal. Do we go for the tie? Well, for right now, we keep the offense out there, hoping maybe they jump offside. We're not going to get it. We call a timeout to talk about with 4 seconds left. Alabama now calls 3 straight timeouts in a row, and we are still out there to go for it. We're going to either win it or lose it here. No, we cannot get in the end zone. Oh, in hindsight, which is always 20-20, of course, I wish I would have run an off-tackle play here with everybody jammed in the middle, but we gave it a shot, and we could not get in the end zone. Alabama hangs onto a game that really they had no business winning. They just did not play well at all, and we hung in there. I mean, our defense did just enough. I mean, our only touchdown came on defense. Looking back, I really feel badly about how I managed the end of the first half. Should have kicked a field goal there, because then the end of the game might have been a field goal to win it, an easy chip shot. And it could have been the upset of the ages. But instead, we're going to have to settle for what could have been on this Saturday afternoon. Colorado State almost shocks number one Alabama. Wow, that would have been a great way to get Bonesaw Bradshaw's first win as a college coach, but nope, it's not to be. He does level up to level 3, and it was an instant classic game, but that's a little consolation. We wanted this W badly. We almost took Bama out, but nope. So we are nearing conference play, which means a lot of user games coming up. Come on back for more action in Burns 2211's Mountain West Dynasty. We'll see you later.